Rocky Jones, Space Ranger.
Space Ranger.
Space Ranger. Starring Richard Crane. In Rocky's Odyssey, Chapter 3.
You know, it's funny, Rocky. People like Bavaro and Torvac think they have to fight each other to exist. But you get them together, talk sense, and they find out that peace and helping each other is the answer.
Goodbye, Bavaro, Torvac.
Why don't you and Cleolana sit down for a nice, quiet little chat?
I tried that once, Winky. Remember? Alert! Alert! Learn this. Destination Earth. Secure for blastoff.
Destination Earth. Best words I've heard in a long time.
All set?
All set, Skipper.
Rocky Jones. This is Rocky Jones. This is Rocky Jones. This is Rocky Jones. This is Rocky.
While Rocky Jones was alive, he was no one's puppet. But now I work the strings which control his voice.
When the Space Ranger's communication band now, Cleolanta.
Whenever you're ready, Atlas San.
XV-2 attempting space station pickup. Can you hear me? Orbis Jet, the XV-2 calling. Come in. Orbis Jet to space station. Can you hear me? Come in.
Rocky! Rocky, you made it. You're alive.
Good to be back. Sorry to cause concern, but today was the first time I could communicate.
Well, you made it, Rocky. That's the only thing that matters. How are the others?
Vina, Professor Newton, Winky, and Bobby are all fine.
Do you need help getting in, Rocky?
I'm not coming in right now, but please arrange a voice relay to Earth.
Of course, Rocky.
And give me a clearance at 1400. I have a message for Secretary Drake. I want to deliver it in my own voice.
Sure, Rocky. And will Drake be glad to hear it? Over until 1400.
Over.
Well, Mr. Secretary, your fondness for the late Rocky Jones is going to lead you into a trap which will entangle all the united worlds of the solar system.
Why must the hands of a clock move so slowly? Won't 1400 ever get here? To think that I shall soon hear Rocky's voice and see his face again. I knew he'd be back. When will it be 1400?
Vina, Professor, Bobby, come forward, please. We're nearing the Space Ranger communication band.
I have the tune-in signal. We should hear something now.
This is Rocky Jones in the Orbit Jet. Come in.
Goodness gracious!
Rocky, who? What is that?
XV-2 to Space Station OW-9. Are you ready with my relay? Come in.
Higgins on OW-9. Ready, Mr. Secretary. Go ahead, Rocky.
Hello, Mr. Secretary. Sorry for the anxiety I've caused, but we couldn't communicate.
Rocky, it's wonderful to hear your voice. Where have you been?
We were trapped by the escape velocity of Sagitta's third moon.
Sagitta? We've never even been to Sagitta. Rocky, what's going on?
Rocky, we'd all given up hope of your return. My best to your crew. Higgins tells me they're all safe.
Yes, Mr. Secretary.
When will you be back?
Mr. Secretary, with your permission, I would like to alter course and head for Ankapore.
Ankapore, Rocky?
Yes, Mr. Secretary. And I urgently request that you meet me there as soon as possible.
It's a trap.
Mr. Secretary, can you hear me? This is Rocky Jones. Can you hear me? Come in. Higgins on the OW-9, can you hear me? Come in.
We can't reach them.
But Rocky, I prefer that you return to Earth. We'll discuss the matter, and if advisable, leave together.
But Mr. Secretary, Ankapore is holding an election to decide whether to join United Worlds or the Ophicians. Klelanta will surely be there, and we'll be too late.
Very well, Rocky. I'll make immediate plans to leave.
Goodbye, Rocky, until we meet on Ankapore.
Goodbye, sir.
And Higgins, I'll refuel on the OW-9, and you'll take command of the spaceship on the flight to Ankapore.
Thank you, Mr. Secretary.
Over and out.
Out, Mr. Secretary.
Well, who is it, Rocky? Who is talking to Secretary Drake?
Klelanta?
Undoubtedly.
But, Rocky, that was your voice.
Partly. They had a recording of my voice, and then mechanically altered another voice to match it. All right, we're underway. We'll get into communication reach of the OW-9 as soon as possible, and expose all this.
Aye, aye, sir.
Goodness gracious!
An infernal meteor.
Quick, Winky. Try to shake it off before the heat spreads.
Yes, sir.
Seal off the control and navigation sections, Winky. And no one is to leave. The meteor struck pretty far back, so the fire doors should hold.
Yes, sir. Where are you going?
Up the escape hatch.
But, Rocky, if the Kron steel of the orbit jet can't stand the heat, what's going to happen to a spacesuit?
Station signal. Rolling over, trying to shake off the meteor, we're completely out of communication.
And Secretary Drake?
He'll be on the moon Ankapore long before our words can reach him.
That's rough, hot work, Rocky. With plenty of hours involved before we can get moving.
Take a rest, Winky. It's my turn.
Oh, but you just got out of there.
Oh, Rocky. What can we do now? How can we ever rescue Secretary Drake? The Ophicians will surely be in control of Ankapore.
Bobby will brief you on future orders.
Bobby?
I'm going to brief you on future orders? The book you're studying, Bobby. The Odyssey.
Oh, sure. Vina, Winky, Professor Newton, we'll all become beggars. And so will Rocky.
Beggars?
Well, goodness gracious.
Ulysses was in a spot just like this. When he got back home, his kingdom was overthrown because folks thought he was dead. In order to find out what was going on and how to stop it, he dressed up like a beggar.
Do you get it, Winky?
No. Maybe I better read that book.
Mr. Secretary, destination Ankapore is directly ahead. I can now request landing permission.
Please do, Higgins, immediately. And find out if Rocky Jones has landed as yet.
Yes, sir.
Space Ranger ship XV-7 requesting landing time. Come in, Ankapore Control.
Moon Ankapore to the XV-7. This is La Volga, elected potentate of Ankapore.
We'll bring you into the subterranean spaceship, Doc.
Yes, sir. And please, sir, has Rocky Jones landed yet?
Several days ago. He's impatiently awaiting the arrival of Secretary Drake.
We'll be right in, sir. Over to Ankapore.
Over and out.
Yes?
Vena, please, may I see Rocky?
Certainly.
I have wonderful news for Rocky, Vena.
Really? Oh, Rocky, it is La Volga.
Hello, Volga.
Secretary Drake has just requested landing clearance.
Fine, be glad to see the old boy.
We've all been anxious for this moment, La Volga. So if you will excuse us, we'll get ready to meet him.
Of course, Vena. Goodbye, Rocky.
Goodbye, La Volga.
It is never old boy. I warned you to refer to Drake with respect.
Oh, Cleolanda, what's the matter?
I am Vena. And don't make the mistake again, Rocky.
All right. How do you expect to handle Secretary Drake?
After staring at this for a while, Secretary Drake will address the universe with words of my choosing. For a poor beggar boy. You sure did a good job, Vena. When will your costume be ready?
Well, I'm almost finished, Bobby.
Goodness gracious, Vena, you can't expect me to wear this.
You know the saying, Professor Newton, and Rocky agrees. Sometimes a good disguise is better than a suit of armor. Come on, let's go show Rocky. Poor, poor beggar boy.
Oh, Bobby.
Now, Rocky, look. Just look at this.
Ankapore is on all frequencies.
This is a proud moment in the history of Ankapore. Secretary Drake is now in Ellipse, and Rocky Jones, who is already in our underground city, has announced that they will both speak to the universe later today.
Yes, this is Cleolanda's work, all right. She'll use my voice and give Drake the hypnotic treatment to force him to say whatever she wants.
Well, we got a long, hard trip ahead of us, Rocky.
And Rocky, once we're there, will they allow us to land?
I believe so, Vena. I understand the city's more like a bazaar than anything else. Anyone is welcome to trade or buy.
Ankapore Control to Space Ranger Ship XV-7. We have you under control. Landing time is now instantaneous. Plus five.
Plus four. Plus three. Plus two.
Here you are, Mr. Secretary. I'll arrange quarters for Higgins, your space ranger, and come back.
Thank you, La Volga.
Yes?
Vena, it is Secretary Drake.
Please, Mr. Secretary, come in.
Oh, Vena, it is so good to...
Why, who are you?
Cleolanta, Mr. Secretary.
And Rocky Jones?
Hiya, boss man.
Allison, no! Sorry, Mr. Secretary, but we fight for different beliefs.
And fight in different ways. Then Rocky Jones isn't alive?
No, Mr. Secretary. You expected the impossible. Bring him over here.
Talking to Rocky Jones for years over the astroform. But I've never seen him. Can't you fix it up for us to get together?
You spoke with Secretary Drake. What did he say?
I can't understand him. He didn't talk like himself. It was a very strange thing.
I saw this guy.
I can understand Vina being busy. The big confab coming up, but why can't I meet Bobby and Professor Newton?
Arms!
Bobby,
arms.
Professor Newton? There was no one with Rocky Jones except Vina and a space ranger.
That must have been Winky.
Yes, that's the name.
But what happened to Bobby and the professor?
Arms! Arms! Arms!
Doubt about it, Rocky. That's Higgins. And he was saying that Secretary Drake didn't act like himself.
Cleo Lana's work.
All right, bigger boy. On your way.
Penny, for a dancing girl? Penny? Pennies for a dancing girl?
Bobby's sure that Space Ranger with La Volga is Higgins. Bring him to the alley. Tell him who you are if necessary, but be sure no one overhears you.
After the meeting, you and your friends will be all together. See my city and enjoy yourself.
Penny? Penny? Penny's for a dancing girl?
I'm sorry, sister. I've got things on my mind.
Higgins, you must listen.
Who knows my name way out here in Ankapore?
I'm Vina. You must recognize my voice from Astrophone. We've talked a dozen times.
Vina? Well, for it. Are you sure you're Vina? Vina from the orbit jet, I mean? Hey, what is this?
Higgins, listen to me.
Yes, Higgins, listen to him.
Oh, so it's Vina again. Now go ahead, tell me you're Winky.
Yeah.
And I suppose you're Rocky Jones.
That's right.
There.
Secretary Drake spoke to me from that opening.
Give me a boost, Winky.
Yes, Mr. Secretary. Rocky Jones will speak, and then you will confirm his words. The entire universe is standing by to hear you both. Atlas Ann, put Rocky Jones' speech on the voice conveyor. Perhaps you'd like to listen to a rehearsal, Mr. Secretary.
Fellow people of the United Worlds, this is Space Ranger Rocky Jones. In one moment, Secretary Drake will speak and confirm my belief that many planets and moons governed by United Worlds truly belong to the Ephesians and that they...
No, no! Rocky would never say a thing like that.
Take him in there. He must be ready to broadcast my message. LaVolga for the opening address. We are ready.
Yes, Cleolana.
Atlas Sam, go in the other room and operate Rocky's voice. You may come back in for a bow afterwards. Please, LaVolga. We are on a five count.
This is a proud moment for me, Vina. This is LaVolga, elected potentan of the Free Moon Ankh-Paw. Secretary Drake and Space Ranger Rocky Jones have seen fit to visit my neutral moon and make a declaration. The next voice you hear will be that of Rocky Jones.
Fellow people of the United Worlds, this is Space Ranger Rocky Jones. At this moment, Secretary Drake cannot speak. But when he can, he will announce a hoax which was perpetrated on LaVolga,
the fine leader of Ankh-Paw, and a hoax which could have done great harm to the United Worlds of the solar system.
Rocky. Rocky Jones.
Rocky, I said it. I knew it, that you'd be back.
Bobby, Vina, Professor Newton, blast off successful. You may come forward.
Well, Bobby, I guess that just about ends our little odyssey. That is, unless there's something else in the book.
That's all. Things got straightened out back in Ithaca like they have in Ankh-Paw with the United Worlds. And Rocky's got Ulysses beat 1,000 ways.
Oh, Bobby.
How's that, Bobby? I thought you always stuck up for that guy, Ulysses.
Well, you know the way our trip has sort of been like the odyssey?
Yeah, go on.
I didn't want to say this before because I didn't want to worry you. But in the odyssey, Ulysses was the only one who got back home alive. His whole crew was lost.
Goodness gracious.